absent. Morning, Paige. Look at all these people popping in here. All right. Three people entered the waiting room. Good morning. Let's see, admit Kaden, admit Bella. Kaden and Bella. Not today. Okay, so let me just see if anybody else is coming in right now. How do I get rid of that? How do I get rid of that thing? Anybody know how to get rid of that thing? Well, I don't want to X because I don't want to X out of it.
I'll ask.
Ah! All right. Let me see. Aha. First, I got to share my screen with these guys. All right. Five participants, 1, 2, 3, 4, and myself is 5. Okay, good, there we go, that's how I got rid of it. Guys, can you see my screen? Just nod if you can. All right, good. Okay, so if you are in the room, turn your screen away from you, please. Okay, so just a couple of things. I'm glad to see people out there in Zoom land. Thank you for coming. Yay. I don't know where to put these things. So I don't know, and I know that people out there in Zoom land heard this yesterday, so just give me a minute. What I have done on the bulletin board, if you notice, if you look up at the bulletin board, let me go turn the lights down in the room a little bit, is I have merged the remote students and the hybrid students. So it's all students now. Why? Because on your remote day, you are supposed to be joining my Zoom class at 8 o'clock for this group, right? Okay. So if you did not join the Zoom class yesterday, you missed, oh, you're the person we need to talk to anyway. You missed, I'm talking to these guys, the lesson. Hold on, Zoom people. Okay, we were gonna ask you anyway because he didn't get an 80s or he didn't get a lunch invitation and he had above 80 and everything else. So we're thinking it's your class. So maybe later you can tell him what his numeric grade was in your class. Okay. Okay, well, there you go. All right. All right, Zoom people, we're back. So I was in the middle of saying to mostly the people in the room, because you guys out there in Zoom land heard this already. If you are not joining the Zoom class at 8 o'clock in the morning, you are missing the lesson for the day. I am not repeating the lesson the next day, okay? I'm running this like a regular class because that's what I've been told to do. So yesterday, what was our lesson that we did yesterday? What did we do, Haley? Because you were with me. We did hyperbole yesterday, right? We watched some videos on hyperbole, and then there is an assignment for hyperbole. So if you missed that yesterday, then you're gonna have to go back and watch the video. I posted the lessons video, so all of first period. And then there's also, I think there's 3 videos about hyperbole, and then what's called a hyperbole sort. There's 2 slides that you have to do the work on. That is due tomorrow, yes. Well, alliteration we did the other day, okay? So if you look, if you look at here, what we're gonna do, you know, I'm trying to put right up at the top to join the Zoom class for everybody. And then, you know, you should always be doing your review games. Today we're gonna do rhyme, okay? So let me escape out of here. I also wanted to show you something else.
I started my rhyme. I just didn't watch the videos because I knew we were gonna watch them in the Zoom meet.
Okay, so that's all right. So here we go. Let me go back to first period and I want to show you a couple of things. So that's the daily bulletin. What I'm doing is I'm trying to push the daily bulletin up at the top Then I'm going to put the Zoom link right underneath that in the stream, and then the study guide, and then anything else. I have posted an extra credit assignment for literary devices. I'm going to go into classwork because I think it'll be easier there. You do not have to do the extra credit. It is if you want to. So let's just take a look at the extra credit. It says to earn extra credit in the literary device unit, have some fun with your favorite song lyrics. And the directions are choose some lines from your favorite songs that have examples of figurative language being used. Identify the device and explain its meaning. So you'll give me a song title. Song titles get put in quotation marks. You're gonna give me the lines that you're working with that you say have figurative language being used. Then you're gonna tell me what device, like what is the figurative language being used? And then you're gonna tell me what it actually means, right? It's raining cats and dogs outside. There are not cats and dogs flying out of the sky, right? Just means it's raining really hard, yes? Okay, the child was a tornado. Doesn't mean the child was a tornado. It means they were crazy and wild like my dog this morning. And I think I asked you to do 5 of those. Listen to me. If you're not doing the regular assignments, don't bother to do the extra credit because it's not going to make you pass. This is for somebody that's struggling with the regular assignments and maybe not doing well and wants to bump up their grade. But if you do one extra credit assignment and no other assignments, it's not really going to make you pass. Okay? Got that, people out there in Zoom land? All right, very good. So that is open. I will accept that. I did not put a due date on this because, you know, it's going to be towards the end of the unit, probably till Thanksgiving or even after. I'm also considering, and I have to look at the calendar again, because I'm thinking I will give you your unit test the day before Thanksgiving break, which is a Tuesday. Okay, so even if you're home on Tuesdays, you'll still be taking the test. And that way we could wrap up literary devices before the break. And then when we come back, we'll start something new. I'm thinking that would be better than to make you take a test when you first come back. Don't you think? Yeah, did you have a question, Kate? Well, where's your charger? Why don't you have your charger? Plug it into the wall. Okay, well, if you have to go to Zoom meetings during the day, you can actually be on a Zoom meeting and have your Chromebook plugged into an outlet at the same time. Like mine is plugged in right now, right? So that's not an excuse that it didn't have any charges if you had your charger with you. That's just not thinking through things. Just saying. Okay, so let's look at today's. Somebody tell me what rhyme is. Bevan? Well, the repeating of the same sound, kind of, sort of, but that's not really the definition of rhyme. Maddie? Words that sound like each other. Do you guys know what, if I asked you what a syllable is in a word, even you people out in Zoom land, you can open your mic up and tell me and raise your hand. Does anybody know what a syllable means? If I say words have syllables, what am I talking about? Anybody? Really? No? Okay, so syllables are beats in a word. You ever count the beats in a word, right? Happy, how many beats does it have? Two beats, right? Every syllable has to have a vowel sound. That's what makes it a syllable. So when you're rhyming, you want to use the ending sound, and it's mostly the ending vowel sound that you're looking for. Cat, hat, fat, right? That A-T sound, yes? All right. So the first thing we're going to do is watch a couple of videos. Again, people at home, I'm not sure how this is going to play through to you. So if it doesn't work on the Zoom, you're going to have to watch the videos later, but just bear with us, okay? So this one's the first one.
Yeah. I know you want to know how to read things, you see things that you want to see. I'll show you how to pick them, speak upon it.
I like their song, their dance.
Let's round words that end in A-T. Cat, chat, chat, rat. Let's round words that end in
O-K. Stop talking.
Cook, look, took, book. Let's round words that end in E-T. Let, met, bet, bet.
rhyme words that end in A-N. Pan, can, man, pan. Let's rhyme words that end in A-C-K. Back, crack, tack, black. Let's rhyme words that end in O-L-D. Sold, mold, fold, told, CD. If you want to read,
I always want to learn this song, this little dance.
Yeah, come on.
I like their shoulders.
If you want to freeze, do the phonics. Now let's rhyme words that end with E-N. Pen, ten, men, hen. Let's rhyme words that end in O-T. Lot, got, blot, not. Let's rhyme words that end in E-L-L. Tell, tell, swell, well. Let's rhyme words that end in A-B. Trap, mat, rap, tax. Let's rhyme words that end in A-Y. Bay, lay.
Beans and Frank, instead of Frank and Beans. Okay, so that's the first one. And that's one of those that you can learn and, you know, record yourself singing or whatever. I always want to try to learn their little dance. I like their little dance. Matt, you got a question?
Yeah.
Not right now. Yeah. We're going to watch the thing. This next video has a lot of rhyme. It also has repetition, right? What's repetition? Word, sound, or idea, right? Repetition is. So Fresh Prince theme song uses rhyme and repetition a lot, okay? Could you stop talking?
Now this is a story all about how my life got the world turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute just
well, Mrs. Grant
like
used to work with me. She used to sing the whole song. I don't know it.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground, as Grandma said, most of my days, chilling out,
nice close
and
relaxing,
all cool and all shooting some.
Oh, I didn't mean to do that, sorry.
With a couple of guys who were up to no good, started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air. I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase to send me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then
Hayden Sweeney. Get the closed caption on that. I'm gonna have to look at that. So if you start to like really pay attention to song lyrics, you'll hear lots of rhyme, right? And lots of repetition. So I thought that actually had a video with it, but apparently it didn't. Okay, so everybody got it? All right, so now you're gonna have to wait a minute. I know you need to go. Okay, you're a big girl, you'll be okay. Let me just go through the directions. You just had a birthday. You're even bigger than you were 2 days ago. Don't give me that look. She's giving me dirty looks out there, people in Zoom land. I'm getting dirty looks from somebody. All right, here we go. This is easy, guys, or it should be. So, rhyming words, okay? A rhyme is a repetition of similar sounds in two or more words. Example, fun, run, or hit, fit. Those are two different ones, right? Write three words that rhyme with each word given below. Example, run, answer, fun, ton, sun, right? So the first one, you have row. Give me some words that rhyme with row. Bow, show, crow. Perfect, okay? So there are 12 of these and you have to give me three rhyming words for each word given. And they're pretty easy because they're only one syllable words. So it's that you have to rhyme with the vowel sound that you hear, okay? This is going to be due on Thursday. Any questions?
Nope.
Okay, so Madison, you may go now. Thank you for waiting. Okay, if you are in the room and you did not Zoom in yesterday and you finish this and turn this in, then you need to look at yesterday's lesson, okay? Anybody have questions for me out there in Zoom land? You guys can get started. Okay, so I'm gonna set you free and you may go, okay? Because I'm gonna end this so the video is not so long when I post it later. All right, have a wonderful day, Zoom land people. Thanks for joining us. Adios, muchachos.
Bye.
Bye. I think what I'm going to do is end this one.